Design of rectangular beam with torsion. Torsion is an important aspect to be considered for the behavior of structure. Axial loads, flexure, shear, torsion are the forces which normally the structure is subjected to. Torsion in a structure usually has secondary effects. The torsion behavior of circular shaft is well known, and the classified theory of elasticity, torsion of non-circular section shafts, thin wall sections has received considerable attention. The modern structure configuration do require study of torsion in detail. If in a reinforced concrete structure, the outer peripheral beams in each floor are subjected to heavy torsion along with flexure and shear. Torsion can be classified into two categories. Equilibrium torsion. This torsion is induced by eccentric loading, and the equilibrium condition alone are sufficient to find the twisting moments. The magnitude of the twisting moment does not depend upon the torsion stiffness of the member and is entirely determined from the statics unknown. Some typical examples are weather shed, cantilever, cyclostand, etc. Okay. So here the moment, torsion moment, twisting moment can be find by the principle of statics. Okay, you don't need the torsion stiffness. You don't require the torsion stiffness to find the twisting moments. Okay, so this is a cyclostand, and this is a cantilever projection, and this is a beam column frame. We will take an example of a cyclostand. A beam framing between the columns has an effective span of 5 meters, okay, and the support and supports a cantilever projection 1.5 meter wide throughout its length. Okay, 1.5 meter projection throughout its length. The width of the beam is 300 mm. Okay, 300 mm. Total working load acting on the cantilever projection is 5 kN/m². Design the rectangular beam as per IS 456-2000. Use M20 grade of concrete and Fe415 steel. Weather conditions are considered to be mild. Okay, so the working load, total working load acting on this cantilever is 5 kN/m². Now this is 2D frame elevation, and we have to design this beam. The width of the beam is 300. Assuming the overall depth of the beam as 5000 by 10, it is 500 mm. Okay, it's a just in thumb rule. We are taking the depth of the beam as 500 mm. Load on cantilever projection per 1 meter width, okay, per 1 meter width, okay, is 5 kN/m², that is our working load, into 1.5, that is the load acting per meter along the beam. Okay, that is 7.5 kN/m. Self weight of beam 0.3 into 0.5 into 25, 3.75. Total factor load W, okay, is equal to 1.5 is the factor load, load factor into 7.5 plus 3.75, that is equal to 16.875 kN/m. Total twisting moment about the center of the beam. Okay, so this is the CG, where the total load of this cantilever slab acts. Okay, so from here the distance from this CG to the center of the beam, okay, that moment will be the twisting moment for this beam. Okay, so total torsion moment about the center of the beam, that is equal to 1.5 into 5 into 5 into 1.5 is our working load, 1.5 is the partial factor of safety, load factor. Okay, so this into the distance of CG from the beam center line. Okay, so this distance from center to the CG, so twisting moment is equal to 1.5 into 5 into 7.5 kN/m² into 1.5 divided by 2 plus 0.3 divided by 2, that is equal to 0.9. Okay, So this TU is equal to 50.625 kilonewton meter. Now that is transmitted to the supports. Okay, half will come to this support, half will go to this support. So maximum torsion moment about each support MT, okay, is equal to 0.5 TU. That is equal to 25.3125. Okay, so this is our TU. The formula which we are using, the formula which is given in the code, okay, where TU, this is the torsional moment we'll be taking, right? Now, our W is 16.875. W is 16.875. So, doing the analysis of this frame, we get the bending moment like this. Bending moment at the left support is 14.69 kilonewton meter. Bending moment at the right hand support is 14.69 kilometer. Bending moment at the center is 38.049 kilonewton meter. And the shear force at left support, it is 42.185. At right support, it is 42.185. At center, it is 0. Twisting moment at left hand support, it is 25.3125. At right hand support, it is 25.3125, and at center it is 0. Okay, so we will design our beam for this twisting moment, the bending moment and shear force. Okay, clause 41.3, shear and torsion. Equivalent shear is given by this formula, where V is the design shear force, TU is the twisting moment or torsion moment, B is the width of the beam. Okay, so equivalent nominal shear stress tau V is equal to VE divided by VD. B is the width of the beam and D is the effective depth of the beam. Okay. Now, clause 41.4. The longitudinal reinforcement shall be designed to resist the equivalent bending moment MET given by formula. MET is equal to design moment M plus the moment due to the torsion moment. Okay. MT is found by this formula. Okay, TU is torsion moment, D is overall depth, B is the width. Okay, so MT is equal to, MT is the total moment for which the beam longitudinal steel has to be designed. Okay, design moment plus MT. Okay, now clause 41.4.2.1, if the numerical value of MT exceeds the numerical value of bending moment M. Okay, if MT is found to be greater than M, okay, if the numerical value of MT exceeds the numerical value of bending moment M at the cross section, the longitudinal reinforcement shall be provided on the flexure compression face. Okay, such that the beam can withstand an equivalent moment, that's ME2 is equal to MT minus M. Okay, the moment ME2 being taken as acting in the opposite side of the moment M, that means the longitudinal steel that is to be provided for ME2 will be on the opposite side for which the we are providing longitudinal steel for our moment MET. Okay, so in short, we will be providing our longitudinal steel in compression, flexure compression phase for ME2. Okay. Okay. Now, this is a table showing the bending moment for which we have to find the longitudinal area of the longitudinal reinforcement. Okay. Left hand support. From here, on left hand support the moment is 14.69, and on right hand support the moment is 14.69. at center it is 38.049. okay, over here we can see left hand support the moment is 14.69, mid span the moment is 38.049, and the right hand support the moment is 14.69. now twisting moment, at left hand support it is 25.3125, 3125. At center it is 0. At right end support it is 25.3125. Okay. So at left end support 25.3125. Midspan 0. And right end support 25.3125. So once you know it to you, you can find MT. So MT is 39.705. So once you know MT, you can find MET. MET is M plus MT. MT. And this is M, right? So this plus this is your total moment for which we have to design the beam. Okay. So this is the moment at left end support, at mid span, and at the right end support, right? So first step, we'll check for the minimum depth. Okay. So we know for the balance section, the minimum, we'll find the minimum depth required. So the section is under reinforced. Okay. For that, we know the formula. MU limit is equal to 0.18 FCKPD square for M20 grade of concrete. Our effective depth is overall depth minus effective cover. We are considering effective cover as 50 mm. So 500 minus 50 mm, that is 450 mm, is our effective depth. The minimum required depth found by this formula should be less than provided. Then only our section will be under reinforced. Okay. So you have to take MU limit, that is the maximum moment. Let us take the maximum moment. Okay, that is 54.4. We get effective depth required, minimum effective depth required as 256.32 for a balanced section. Okay. Our depth, effective depth provided is 450 mm, which is greater than 256.32. So our section is singly under reinforced section. Okay. Now, as per clause 41.4.2.1, when MT is greater than M, okay, you can see over here MT is greater than M, MT is less than M, MT is greater than M, okay. When MT is greater than M, then ME2 will come in picture, right? MT minus M, okay. So over here MT is greater than M at support. Then we have to provide longitudinal steel at bottom for moment ME2 is equal to MT minus M. So ME2 is equal to MT, that is 39.705, okay, minus M, 14.69, okay. As on left and right, left support and right support, MT and the moment are same, okay. So we will calculate for one side, okay. So this is true for both the supports, right? So we will have to provide longitudinal steel for the moment 25.015 on the compression face, okay. At support, the tension is at top, okay. So the compression will be at bottom. So we will have to provide the longitudinal steel at bottom, okay. Now, as per clause 41.4.2.1, that is for positive bending moment at mid-span, okay, MT is 0. And so MT is 0. MT is greater, less than M. So no extra longitudinal steel has to be provided, okay, for ME2. Now, let us form a table. Now, on left-hand support, MET is 54.4. At mid-span, MET is 38.05. At right-hand support, MET is 54.4. Okay. And ME2 is equal to 25.015. So we can use this formula because our section is singly under reinforced section. So this is the area required. This is the minimum AST that has to be provided. Okay. You can find by this formula. So we will provide at left end support, this is the required, we will provide 402 mm square, that is two number of 16 mm bars at top, okay. We can see the detail. Okay, at left end support, we are providing two 16 mm bars for a length of 1.5 meters, okay. Now, mid span. This is the required area. We are providing 339, that is 3 bars of 12 mm dia, okay, that is at the bottom, okay. So we are providing 3 numbers of 12 mm dia bar at the bottom. This is mid span. Okay. Now, right in support, this is the area of steel required. We will provide 402 mm square, that is two number of 16 mm dia bars at top. Okay. Okay, this is right in support. Over here, we will provide two 16 mm dia bars. Okay, for a length of 1.5 meters. Right. Okay. Now, ME2 is the moment for which we have to provide the longitudinal steel in the compression zone near the support. Okay, the compression is at bottom, right? So steel required is 157, minimum AST required is 276. So for here also, we'll, for conveniency of detailing of reinforcement, we'll provide the same steel as required in the mid span. Okay, so we'll provide three number of 12 mm dia bars at the supports in the compression zone. Okay, so this is the compression zone at the support. Okay, so over here we also we provide three numbers of 12 mm dia bars. Over here also three numbers of 12 mm dia bars. So three number of 12 mm dia bars are run throughout the beam. Okay, so this is how we do the detailing for the longitudinal reinforcement. Okay, in between over here also we provide 3 mm dia bar. Okay, and the splicing, this bar has to be spliced with the 16 mm dia bar. The splicing length should be greater than 50 times the dia of the bar. Okay, now after doing the calculation for the longitudinal steel, now you have to do the check for shear. Okay, so this is the formula given in the code. Okay, for finding the area of steel obliques. Okay, and this formula is valid for two leg closed stirrups. Okay, say suppose you have a beam section like this and you are providing a four leg stirrups. Okay, and then the code is given this formula in which only area of two legs has to be considered. Okay, and that also the outer face legs which are at the periphery, the inside two legs. Okay, these two legs are assumed to be ineffective in taking the shear due to torsion. Okay, the effective legs are the legs at the on the periphery, right? So these legs will be effective in taking the shear for due to torsion, right? And whereas this vertical two legs which are inside are assumed to be ineffective. Okay, so that is why whether you provide a four legged or six legged or two legged, okay, but the effective area of the legs will be considered that is for the two legged closed stirrups. Okay, so this is considered as two legged closed stirrup. Okay, so that is the main assumption in this formula. Okay, so you can formulate this. This is a spacing. The spacing is equal to this much, right? Now whatever spacing we find has to be less than the smaller of this five. Okay, the spacing should not be greater than the least of the following. Okay, these are the five conditions: 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, now so before starting the check for shear, first we were to find B1, D1, Y1 and X1. Okay, so B1 is the center to center horizontal distance between the corner bars. D1 is the vertical distance between the corner bars. Okay, then Y1 is the vertical distance between the center to center of the stirrups, right? And X1 is the horizontal distance between the center to center distance of the two vertical legs. Okay, so this is what we have already found over here, and we will require this values while doing the check for one way shear. Okay, okay, so effective shear VE is found from this formula. This V is the design shear force. Okay, that is 42.185 at the supports. Okay, So 42.185 is the shear force, and we know that the torsion twisting moment is 25, torsion moment is 25.3125, okay, and B is 0.3, that is width of the beam, okay. Our beam is 300 by 500 mm, so this turns out to be 177.185. So nominal shear stress is V divided by BD, that is equal to 1.312 Newton per mm square. Now AST provided its support. AST provided its support is 402 mm square, okay. So AST provided at support is 402 mm square, so PTE is found to be 0.298. for this PTE, tau c is found to be 0.39 Newton per mm square when the grade of concrete is M20, using table 19 of IS 456-2000, right. Now tau c is less than tau v, but tau v should not be greater than tau v max. Tau v max is equal to 2.8 Newton per mm square for M20 grade concrete, table 20, IS 456-2000, okay. If your tau v is found to be greater than tau c max, then you will have to revise the cross section, okay. The section will not be permitted. But now, as tau c is less than tau v and tau v is less than tau c max, so shear, we can provide shear reinforcement. Shear reinforcement shall have to be provided to take the additional shear force. We will provide two leg 8 mm stirrups so that ASV is equal to 100.48 mm square, that is the area of two legs of the stirrups. Okay, area of 8 mm die bar is 50.24 into 2, that is 100.48. So put the values of B1 and D1, we have already calculated over here, okay. We get spacing is equal to 110.86 mm, where this V is the design shear force, 42.185 kilonewton, okay. So we will provide two leg 8 mm stirrups about 100 mm center to center, okay, at the supports for 1.5 meters, okay, because the shear force V at both the support is the same, okay. So the detailing of reinforcement on both the supports, okay, will be the same, okay. So this is 100 mm center to center for 1.5 meter length on either side of the support. So 1.5 meters, you have to provide two leg 8 mm dia stirrups about 100 mm in this area, okay, right, okay. Now this spacing has to be less than least of this, right. So this is 242, this is 168, this is 300, this is 131.15, this is 337.5, okay. So our 100 mm spacing is less than least, that is 131.515, so it's okay, right, okay. So now as we move toward the center, okay, the shear force and the twisting moment decreases, okay. So the requirement of the stirrups will be less over here, right. So in this area we will provide 2 leg 8 mm dia about 200 mm center to center, okay. So this is how we do the detailing of the beam, okay. Now the code says when the beam is carrying torsion along with bending moment and shear, and then the overall depth when found to be greater than 450 mm, then you have to provide face bars, okay. Our overall depth is 500 mm, okay, so we will have to provide face bars. So we will have to provide face bar for a minimum area required 0.1% into B into D, okay. Sorry, this is capital D, okay. Right. So that is equal to 150 mm square. Now we are providing 210 mm dia bars, one on each face, whose area is 2 into 78.5, that is 157 mm square, which is greater than 150 mm. So it is okay. You can see this is the face bar, okay. These are the two face bar, one on each face, right. Now the second requirement is the spacing between this should not be greater than 300 mm, okay. The 300 mm or the least dimension of the beam, okay. The least dimension of the beam is 300, And the required spacing is also 300. Maximum spacing is 300 mm. So our spacing should not be greater than 300 mm. So this is 500 minus 50 mm is the effective cover. Over here, minus 50 mm is the effective cover. So 500 minus 100, that is 400 divided by 2. So this spacing is 200. This spacing is 200, which is less than 300. So it is okay, right? All right. Now coming to the second type of torsion, compatibility torsion. It is the torsion induced in the member due to the compatibility of rotation of secondary beam connected to primary beam in interconnected joints. Okay, this is our secondary beam, this our primary beam. Okay, if this beam undergoes a rotation of theta b, then this beam will also undergo a twisting angle, a twist. This beam will also twist with an angle theta b, right? Because these are monolithic connection and they are interconnected. Okay, the twisting moment induced are directly dependent on torsion stiffness of the member. These twisting moments are statically indeterminate, and this their analysis involves compatibility condition. The rotation of secondary beam, this is theta, okay, this is theta b, okay, and this is not p, please take it as theta, okay. The rotation of secondary beam theta b at the end of the angle of twist theta b for the primary beam at the point of interconnection b is shown in figure. Okay, same which I explained you, that the rotation which this beam, secondary beam, goes will the same amount this beam will twist. Okay, if this is theta b, then this the angle of twist over here will be also theta b. Okay, due to the loading of the secondary beam, okay, this is secondary beam. Due to the loading of the secondary beam, it will undergo a deflection with a rotation theta b. Please take theta b, okay, at point b as a primary beam is monolithically connected with the secondary beam at point b, okay, deformation compatibility at b implies an angle of twist equal to theta b in the spandrel beam at point b. Okay, the bending moment developed at b in the secondary beam will be equal and opposite to the twisting moment in the primary beam at point b to satisfy the equilibrium. The magnitude of the theta b, please, this is not pb, this is theta b. Okay, the magnitude of theta b, twisting moment, bending moment at b, depends upon the torsional stiffness of the spandrel beam and the flexure stiffness of the secondary beam. Okay, so let us try to understand this through an example. Okay, we have a frame like this. Design beam b1 and b2 of the frame, which carries twisting moment, bending moment and shear force as shown in table below. Okay, so this is b1, this is b2, this is the bending moment. Okay, now these are the bending moment, twisting moment and shear force given to us. This is joint 1, joint 2, joint 3. The span is 5 meters. Okay, okay, at joint 1 for member b1, okay, this is member b1. At joint 1, where the moment is 60 kilonewton meter, at center over here it is 65.75, and over here it is 13 kilonewton meter. Similarly, this is 13 kilonewton meter, this is 65.75 kilonewton meter, this is 60 kilonewton meter. Okay, so this is how the moment are acting on the beam. Twisting moment 30 at the support, 0 at mid-span, 30 at the support. Again 30, 0 and 30. Okay, now shear force 60 at this support and 85 at this support, 85 at this support and 60 at this support. Okay, now the moment shear force and twisting moment in case of B1 and B2 are identical. Okay, so we'll design B1 and the same design will be followed for B2. Okay, use M20 grade of concrete, Fe415 steel. Assume the effective cover equal to 50 mm. Okay, so this is the table which we have made. for member number one, that is B1. Okay, gravity moment due to gravity at left hand support, it is 60. Mid span, it is 60.75. Right hand support, it is 13. Okay, now twisting torsion moment, twisting moment 30 at left hand support, 0 at the mid span, 30 at the left hand support. Right, this is left hand support and this is right hand support. So 30 at the right hand support. Okay, this is right hand support. Now once you know the twisting moment, you can find MT using this formula. Okay, so this is MT 49.50 49.5. So MET is equal to M plus MT. This plus this is 109.5. This plus this is 65.75. This plus this is 62.5. Okay, so first step, find the minimum D. Okay, at least minimum depth required. Okay, by using this formula, MU limit is equal to 0.138 fck/m² for M20 grade concrete. Our effective depth provided is capital D minus effective cover. Effective cover is 50. 450 minus 50, that is 400 mm. Okay, so we are providing effective depth D equal to 400 mm, and the minimum effective depth required is MU limit, take the maximum moment 109.5, is 398.3, which is less than 400 mm. So our section is singly underreinforced section. Okay, now as you as per clause 41.4.2.1, where MT is greater than M, over here MT is less than M, over here MT is less than M, over here MT is greater than M. Okay, so at right hand support, we will have to provide extra longitudinal steel for moment ME2 at the bottom. Okay, so MT is greater than M at about support 2, right? So there extra longitudinal steel has to be provided at bottom for moment ME2 is equal to MT minus M. Okay, MT is 49.5 and M is 13. Okay, so this is 36.5. So we have to provide additional longitudinal steel at support 2 at bottom for this moment. Okay, now as per clause 41.4.2.1, for positive moment at mid span, okay, MT is 0, which is less than M, so no extra longitudinal steel has to be provided. Okay, even at support, left hand support, MT is less than M, so over there also no extra longitudinal steel is required at the bottom, right? And in the flexure compression phase, you can say. Now these are the total MET. okay, left support MET is 109.5, mid spine MET is 65.75, right support MET is 62.5, and ME2 at the support 2, okay, that is right hand support, is 36.5. So according to this, this is the AST required, this is AST minimum. Okay, our steel should be greater than AST minimum. Okay, so we, this is the provided steel. Instead of this, we are providing 1005 mm², that is 5 numbers of 16 mm dia bars at top for the left hand support. Okay, so we'll see it in the detail. This is B1. Okay, at left hand support, we are providing 5 numbers of 16 mm dia bars for a length 1.5 meters. Okay, now again coming to the table, mid span, this is the required area. We are providing 515, that is 2 16 mm dia bars plus 1 12 mm dia bars at the mid span bottom steel. Okay, so we will see that. Okay, this is the mid span, we are providing 2 16 mm dia plus 1 12 mm dia bar. Okay, now coming to the right hand support. Okay, this is the area required. We are providing 515. Okay, so this is provided at the top of the right hand support, that is equal to 2 16 mm plus 1 12 mm dia bar. Okay, so this is the common junction, right? So this is provided as 2 16 mm dia bar plus 1 12 mm dia bar. Okay, now coming to MET, ME2, right? This is the moment, this is steel required. Okay, but still the steel required is less, but we are providing more. Okay, to keep the reinforcement same for the ease of detailing. Okay, So over here at the support 2 at bottom, we are again providing 515 mm square area of steel, that is 216 mm dia bars plus 112 mm dia bar, that is we have to provide over here, okay, below the right end support. Okay, tension is over here, compression is over here, so that steel we have to provide over here. So what we are doing, we are simply just running this 216 mm dia bar plus 112 mm dia bar throughout, okay, so it becomes easy in detailing, right? So this is how we can do the longitudinal steel detailing, okay. And this in between area, we are continuing two corner bars, okay. So over here there are five numbers of 16 mm dia bars, but after that two bars at the common, 216 mm dia bars at the common are continued for the whole beam, okay. So another three 16 mm dia bars are curtailed over here, and another three 16 mm dia bars are curtailed over here for this case, right? Over here it is 216 plus 12 mm, 112 mm, okay, so 112 mm dia bar is curtailed over here, right? So 216 mm dia bars are running throughout the continuous beam, okay. So now we come to the check for shear, right? Same formula, this is the formula which is valid for two leg closed stirrups. This is very important, closed stirrups, okay, that is closed stirrups, okay. So we are just considering the area of legs that are on the outer periphery, okay, vertical legs. So we are just considering two leg stirrup, okay. So this can be formulated as this, okay. And whatever spacing we get, the spacing should not be greater than the least of the following, okay, this five. So B1, D1, Y1, X1 are found over here, okay. So our V at support 2, okay, joint 2 is our right end support, okay. Over here, this is joint 2, right end support. The shear force is 85 kN, okay, over here. So we'll take 85 kN in consideration, right? Okay, so V is taken as 85 over here, okay. So VE is found to be 277. Nominal shear stress tau V is found to be 2.77. This should be less than tau C max. Tau C max is 2.8, okay. So this is less than tau C max, so it is safe, okay. Now area of steel provided at that support, that is right end support, area of steel provided is 515 mm square, okay. So 515 mm square is the area provided. For this you have to find the PT, that is 0.515%. For this PT you have to find tau C, okay, for M20 grade concrete from table 19 IS 456-2000, which is 0.48. Now tau C is less than tau V, so we will have to provide shear reinforcement, okay. As tau C is less than tau V and tau V is less than tau C max, shear reinforcement shall have to be provided to take the additional shear force, okay. Now we will provide two leg 10 mm dia stirrups. ASV is equal to 157 mm square, okay. Area of one leg of 10 mm dia bar is 78.5 into 2 is 157, okay. Area of two legs of stirrups, right? So as we, you know, B1, D1, V, okay, we are taking as 85, okay. V is the design shear force, right? So this spacing is found to be 93.3, okay. So we will provide two leg 10 mm dia stirrups about 90 mm center to center up to a length of 1.5 meters, okay. So we can see over here, we are taking, now considering this support, okay. So for 1.5 meters, we are providing 10 mm, two leg stirrups about 90 mm center to center in this distance, right? Now, we know our spacing should be, whatever spacing we get over here, should be less than this 5, right? So this is 192, this is 143.5, this is 300. This is 99.01, this is 300. So 90 is less than least, that is 99.01. So it's okay, safe, right? Now, coming to the next support, the left hand support, that is joint one, okay? So equivalent shear force VE is equal to VVA over there is 60 kilonewton, right? Shear force at joint one. We are now considering this face, okay, this support. The shear force is 60, okay? Shear force is 60 over here, right? So we are taking 60 over here, right? We are taking 60 over here. So VE is equal to 252. Nominal shear stress is 2.52. Area of steel provided at left end support. Area of steel provided at left end support is 1005, right? So over here we will take area is 1005. So PT is found to be 1%. Okay. For this percent of steel, an M20 grade of concrete from table number 19, IS 456-2000, we get tau C is equal to 0.62 Newton per mm square. Now tau C is less than tau V, okay, but tau V should be less than tau C max. Tau C max is 2.8 Newton per mm square for M20 grade of concrete, table 20, IS 456-2000, right? Okay, so that is tau V is less than tau C, so okay, otherwise we would have to change the section, right? So as tau C is less than tau V is less than tau C max, we can provide additional shear reinforcement. Okay, shear reinforcement shall have to be provided to take the additional shear force. We will provide two leg 10 mm dia stirrups. The area of two legs of stirrups is 157, right? Now spacing again found by using this formula is 97.9, where V is 60 kilonewton, right? Design shear force. We will provide 10 mm dia about 90 mm center to center for a length up to 1.5 meters. Okay, so we come over here. Okay, in this is support, left hand support or joint one. Over here we will provide 10 mm two leg stirrups about 90 mm center to center, right? So this beam, two beams are identical. So shear reinforcement provided over here is provided over here. Shear reinforcement provided over here is provided over here, right? Now, whatever spacing we got over here, okay, has to be less than least of this five. This is 192, this is 143.5, this is 300, this is 119.3. And this is 300, okay? So we are providing 90 mm, that is lesser than 119, so it is okay and safe, okay? Now as we move towards the center, the twisting moment and the shear force decreases. So in this region we will provide two leg 10 mm dia about 180 mm, two leg 10 mm dia about 180 mm, okay? So this is how we do the detailing of the beam with torsion, right? Now over here the code says, when a flexure member is carrying torsion along with bending moment and shear force, and if the overall depth of the beam is greater than 450 mm, then we have to provide face bars. Our overall depth is 450, okay? So still it is not required, but it is at the you can say at the ultimate limit, okay? You can say when the beam is greater than 450 mm, our beam is 450 mm. So to be on safer side, let us provide face bar. Okay. So we'll provide face bar, 210 mm dia, okay, one in on each face. Okay. So the area, minimum area required for the face bar is 0.1% of BD. Okay. This is capital D. Okay. So this area is turned out to be 112.5 mm square. We are providing 210 mm dia bars, so the area is 157, greater than 157 mm square, so that's okay. Okay, now the spacing, this spacing should not be greater than 300 on the least dimension of the beam. The least dimension of the beam is 250 mm. This spacing should not be greater than 250 mm. Okay, But our spacing is 450 minus 50 mm effective cover minus 50 mm effective cover, that is 350 divided by 2, that is 175, which is less than 250 mm. So it is on the safe side. Okay. Now comes checks for the deflection at the midspan. We are doing check for deflection at the midspan for beam B1. Okay. We know L by D allowable is equal to L by D basic into KT into KC. KT is obtained from figure 4. Okay. And KC is obtained from the figure 5 of IS 456 2000. Okay. According to clause 23.2.1, for continuous beam, L by D basic is equal to 26. Modification factor for tensile reinforcement KT. Okay, at midspan, the area of steel is 515 mm square. Okay, let us see the table. At midspan, the steel we have provided is 515 mm square. Okay. Okay, so this is the provided steel and this is the required steel. Okay, so FS is found to be 237.89. So we'll take the graph of 240, okay, Newton per mm square. And from that graph, we get KT is equal to 1.2, okay. Now, modification factor for compression reinforcement KC from figure 5, okay, PC, percentage PC is equal to area of steel provided is 402. At mid-span, at bottom, we are providing area of steel is 515 mm square. At top, it is 216 mm dia bars, okay. So the area of this bar will be 402 mm square, right. So the area of steel provided is 402 mm square and this is equal to 0.402%. For this percent, we get KC is equal to 1.125 from graph 5 of IS 456 2000. So our formula becomes L by D allowable is equal to L by D basic into KT into KC, that is 26 into 1.2 into 1.125, that is 31.35.1. Okay. L by D actual is equal to 5000 by 400, that is 12.5 less than 35.1, so okay, and safe in deflection criteria. Okay. Now, as according to clause 41.1.1 IS 456 2000, the above formulas can also be applied for flange beams. Okay. Of course, by using this formula, you will get conservative results. Okay. What you have to do is you have to replace B by BW. BW is the width of the web. Okay. Say for example, in this formula, okay, when you are finding your equivalent shear, instead of B, you have to take BW over here. And for finding the equivalent moment, okay, in this formula, instead of B, you have to take BW over here, right? So this is a small change you have to make in the formula when you want to design a flange member which is carrying a torsion along with bending moment and shear force. Okay, so I hope you must have found this video useful. Thank you very much.